I was shaping in iniquity.
Behold, I was shaping in iniquity.
Read one more time.
Behold, I was shaping in iniquity.
Read on.
And in sin.
And in what?
Sin.
Read on.
Did my mother conceive me?
And in sin did my mother conceive me.
Today, why are they calling it a sin when she had a baby?
Then continue in the blood of a purifying.
Okay.
3 and 30 days.
Okay, so now the blood of her purifying is the time that the Lord is giving, the time that the Lord has allotted for the sister to be cleansed in the eyes of God, to be purified. Do everybody understand that? Everybody got that, right? Okay, so this has nothing to do with being unclean as the separation, which is the normal 7-day cycle. This is the Lord is saying that she needs 33 more days to be purified from her sin. Purified, or another word for purified is cleansed from her sin. Do everybody understand that? Everybody got that? Read on.
Middle of verse 4. She shall touch no hallowed thing, nor come into the sanctuary, until the days of her purifying be fulfilled.
So the days of her purification is different than the menstrual cycle. She has to be purified or cleansed from her sin. For all those days, she cannot come into the sanctuary. Do everybody understand that? Nor touch any hallowed thing. Like the brother asked, if she was the wife of a priest, she couldn't, and the priest always had the hallowed things of the Lord around him. She couldn't touch the hallowed thing. She still was being purified from her sin. Read on.
Verse 5.
Come on.
But if she bear a maid child, then she shall be unclean 2 weeks.
Okay, so if she bear a maid child, then she shall be unclean 2 weeks. So read on.
As in a separation.
Okay, so it's 2 weeks, which is 14 days, as in the days of her separation. So it would be double as if she was respecting the law of having her cycle. Do everybody understand that? Now, to deal with the sister's question, if it's twins, it doesn't matter. The only thing that matters is whether it's male or whether it's female. The time period doesn't change. Do everybody understand that? If it's male or it's female is the only thing that needs to be decided. If it's twins and it's one a male and one is a female, then she will follow the female time period of being unclean. Do everybody understand that? If it's two males, then she will follow the normal time period of being unclean. Do everybody understand that? Read on.
And she shall continue in the blood of a purifying 66 days.
Go ahead.
And when the days of a purifying are fulfilled, for a son or for a daughter.
Go ahead.
She shall bring a lamb of the first year for a burnt offering.
Okay, because for a son or for a daughter, the time period is different. Let's go back up to Leviticus chapter 12, verse 2, and let's focus on the days of her purification. Let's focus on that. Read Leviticus chapter 12, verse 2 one more time. The days of her separation, excuse me. Read that one more time.
Speak unto the children of Israel, saying, if a woman that conceived seed and born a man child, then she shall be unclean 7 days.
Okay, y'all see that word there? How many days?
7 days.
How many days?
7.
Okay, 7 days. All right, so I want to clear this up. I want to be clear. So there can be no confusion on sisters wondering when they become clean, you know, when they could come back into the sanctuary after they had their cycle. 7 days is what the Lord says. 7 days. A day is a 24-hour period. Do everybody understand that? Everybody got that? You don't count it down to the hour, because it ain't, you know, you don't count it down to the hour, but you count it according to the day. So let's use Friday as an example, being that the Friday evening is a Sabbath. If a woman became unclean on a Friday evening, she would become clean again. She will be able to enter the sanctuary again the next Friday evening. I want everybody to understand that and be clear on that. If she became unclean on a Friday evening, next Friday in the evening, she will be clean to come into the sanctuary. If we are in the summertime hours, that means that the prayers probably will start at 7 o'clock. It would still be the daytime. It wouldn't be the evening yet. She can't come into the sanctuary. She has to wait until the evening comes, till the sun goes down, then she can come into the sanctuary. On a Friday, in the daytime, if she become unclean, the next Friday, in the daytime, she will be clean to come into the sanctuary. Do everybody understand? Everybody got that? Is that clear? is it simple. You count 7 days, right? You don't count Friday because that's not, if you became unclean on Friday, you don't count Friday because that's not a whole day yet, right? But what you will count? You will count Saturday, Sunday, month to the next Friday. Everybody understand that? Everybody got that? All right, read it one more time.
Verse 2.
Come on.
Speaking to the children of Israel, saying, if a woman had conceived seed and born a man-child, then she shall be unclean 7 days.
7 days. Some confusion comes in sometime because the Sabbath is from evening to evening. The scripture says this, that in the evening and the morning was the first day. So some people think that 7 days mean from the evening to the evening. This 7 day process here is talking about a 24 hour period day. Do everybody understand that? Everybody got it? Not an evening to the evening that makes it one day. Everybody got that, right? Okay, that needs to be cleared up. Read on.
According to the days of the separation, for her infirmity shall she be unclean.
Okay, so when she has a baby, the Lord will consider that bleeding that takes place to be the bleeding of the menstrual cycle. So she has to be put apart 7 days for a male child. Everybody understand that? Everybody got it? Let's go back to Leviticus chapter 15, verse 19. I'm going to show you some more in there. Leviticus chapter 15, verse 19. We had a place that was the place of separation for females to go when they became unclean with their menstrual cycle. Now, as we rehearse the righteous acts, brothers and sisters, they do that different ways. Some brothers, you know, and sisters, some sisters don't stay in the same room with their husbands when they have their menstrual cycle. Some sisters don't cook for the family when they have their menstrual cycle. Some sisters do cook for the family when they have their menstrual cycle. There's nothing wrong with that. Everybody understand that? Y'all looking at me strange. The brother can't cook and you only went up in there, you know, everybody going to starve. I mean, that's where the governance of the man comes in at. How you going to run your household and keep the laws of God according to what's best for your household. Do everybody understand that? You're supposed to be able to make those decisions. Everybody got that? There's no such thing as being over-righteous or when it comes to that, because you know what's best for your household. If a brother, you know, don't have her cooking or don't have her in the same room, there's nothing wrong with that. But that don't mean that's the way you have to run your household. Do everybody understand that? Everybody got that? Some brothers may have them sleeping on the floor. I don't know too much about that. But if the sister's in agreement with the floor, then that, you know, that's a joke. Right? Okay, what verse we in?
Leviticus 15, 19.
Read it.
And if a woman have an issue, and an issue in her flesh be blood, she shall be put apart 7 days. And whosoever toucheth her shall be unclean until the evening.
Okay, y'all see that. So whosoever toucheth her shall be unclean until the evening. Okay, do everybody understand that? That uncleanness until the evening is, again, if it's in the evening of the, already in the evening when you touched her, then you would be unclean until the next evening. Do everybody understand that? If it's the morning time or the daytime, then you will be unclean. Depending on how the day works, you will be unclean until that evening. Read on.
Verse 20. And everything that she lieth upon in a separation shall be unclean. Everything also that she sitteth upon shall be unclean.
Go ahead.
And whosoever toucheth her bed shall wash his clothes and bathe himself in water and be unclean until the evening.
Go ahead.
And whosoever toucheth anything that she sat upon shall wash his clothes and bathe himself in water and be unclean until the evening.
Come on.
And if it be on her bed or on anything whereof she sitteth, when he toucheth it, he shall be unclean until the evening. And if any man lie with her at all, and the flowers be upon him, he shall be unclean 7 days.
Okay, so again, don't get it misconstrued. You're supposed to keep the law according to the best of your ability that you're in the house. You're not just supposed to disregard the law. Do everybody understand that? It's supposed to be according to your situation. That's when there's nothing wrong with it. Do everybody understand that? Everybody got that? But you're just not supposed to allow a sister that's unclean to just do things that she necessarily shouldn't have to do because she's under the laws of separation. Do everybody understand that? All right, what verse we need?
End of 24.
Come on.
And all the bed whereon he lieth